on Saturday. The experts who will be making their way here to the forecourt of Love 99.5 from Kofanochi will psych them, will counsel them, will talk to them for them to get to know that it's that easy.
Okay. I think I'll put myself in the equation. I remember the first time I was asked to donate blood. I actually went through all the processes, but when I saw the syringe,
the needle,
I had to live. But growing forward, I've had people talk to me and not even thinking about the needle and all. You sit back and you ask yourself, okay, what if? Just what if you could help someone? So do away with all the fears and whatever it is that you think it's a hindrance. Just sit back and ask yourself, what if that pint of blood of yours could save somebody's life? What if? And be here on Saturday and help.
All right. The reason why I asked you to sit, first of all, was to hear you speak the way you've just spoken.
Thank you.
But the other one too is this, which of course is very, very, very important to me.
Yeah,
I've been tasked to be the person, the registrar. So I've been registering people for the blood donation. So you come in, I register, put down your name, take a few details from you, give you your number, and then you go and do your donation. Put that one aside. I know that NGO and African Child and Kofi Diakwa, they'll be referees for the games. So they will be going around to ensure that the games are going well and all that. But you, Anita, Gloria, you are the nurses
of the day.
So how long or short is your nurse attack going to be? I don't even know this one.
From 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. it will be over.
Okay, so I want Deborah to be the person who choose your clothing.
Oh, okay.
As a nurse.
Wow.
You know why?
No, tell me.
You know why?
Tell me.
He said something to you and I on Monday.
Really?
So you want me to go on there and say it?
No, don't say it.
So you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know.
So Deborah will choose your... Hey, thank you very much, Anika. And of course,
welcome,
she's
baby.
The ambassador for the blood donation drive or exercise coming off on Saturday. Please be here and donate a pint to save a soul. Well, it's Christmas, so I'm not going to play my Mission Impossible tune. This is the tune I have for you.
To certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay. Oh, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so
and loves Christmas. And Anika is singing beautifully to this very song. So is one of my panel, Dr. Ernest Kwaku, a public interest advocate and, of course, a gynecologist at the Kofanochi Teaching Hospital. And also, he is into public health. He's a practitioner, and he's right here with me in the Cities of Love 99.5 as well. Tomorrow, I have a surprise for you, especially for those of you who love Christmas and Christmas carols. I'm going to have kids ranging between the ages of 8, 9, 11, and I think 12. And they'll be here tomorrow with their own instruments, from flutes to trumpets to saxophone and drums. And they'll be performing right here in the Studios of Love 99.5 live carols. They'll be coming from D&D Academy. Trust me, you wouldn't want to miss out for anything. They are so good that you would love to listen to their performance and sing along. Dr. Ernest Kwaku, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon, David Akwete.
And how are you doing?
By grace.
All right,
fine. I'm already in the Christmas mood.
I know you are, because I know you're singing.
And
a while ago, you were telling me that I'm showing my sakura. What are you showing yourself? You also sakura.
We belong to the brothers of the same fraternity. But so that I don't lose my touch, and then... I finish a part to all faithful listeners of
We're grateful to them.
Without them, it wouldn't be a show.
Yeah.
So we are so grateful to them. And a special birthday wish to young man, Miles Asensu Mensah, who is 1 year old today. Mm.
Did you deliver the mother of this baby?
This one, I think I have a duty as a doctor to keep confidentiality. So
the patient doctor.
So you know, I will not answer. But it's wonderful to the Christmas bonds, the Christmas month, bring up babies.
Yeah,
they are so lucky. If any one out there who is listening, who was born in the Christmas month, especially the second half, you are all Brunya babies, and I wish you a very Merry Christmas and Happy Birthday.
Do you know? Okay, take a wild guess. What date would you say in the month of December, was Delali born?
Delali, 25th?
No.
Oh, I missed it.
You were quite close though.
I missed it. Maybe 24th.
Yeah, 24th.
You should have let me say the 24th instead of getting Delali at Yase. Well, 24th. He's in there in the newsroom.
Yeah, preparing for
yes.
Three.
So happy birthday to you too. Indeed, to all December borns, especially in the second half.
No, so we're in here. We're having a conversation. We're laughing. You know, we are all in a spirit of Christmas, but unfortunately,
some things are not laughing matters.
Yes. Last weekend, we all know what hit us on social media. We're teenagers. If you listen to the PR of the Ghana Police Service here in the Shanti region, she says that one of them is in GSS. The other two who have been arrested also from SSS, and they're looking for other four accomplices who are alleged to have raped this girl. The video was shown to me, and trust me, I was not able to bring myself to watch the video. I couldn't even watch 30 seconds of it. I could not.
But it's terrible, dehumanizing.
Very.
And I'll look at this thing from two fronts. One from a preventive angle, and then the other from a moral angle.
But before you do, what would you say this generation is coming to? Yeah. Because even on social media, over the past few years, we see crazy things happen. If you have the audacity to do something that is wrong in terms of raping somebody, and then you are filming it,
you have the audacity to film it
and then what kind of a society,
and then publish it,
and so ask myself, what kind of society are we building? As parents, have we failed? Are we failing?
Well, then you are making me start from the moral angle, because I wanted to put that to second, but let me start my rant. I was horrified. Yes, I'm a gynecologist. We deal with cases like that. We assist the police and assist the victims, their health, and they assist psychiatry and psychotherapy, and then we assist the law. But trust me, this one is so dehumanizing. It's horrible, so distasteful. Let me say this. I don't think that we have to substitute modernity for moral decadence. That's what we seem to be doing. We are getting sophisticated, we are developing. Is that what you call development? When we are getting primitive, that's primitive instinct. Even with the greatest research, do you see animals 10 or 20 rushing onto the same? It's so horrible. And you see what? I say it again. We don't have to substitute modernity with moral decadence. That's what we seem to be doing. Look, we think that things are becoming cool. We are growing so tolerant to everything. How dare you?
What would you place?
How dare you?
What would place blame here? Because over the years, it seems and looks as if we have not punished these people well enough.
In terms
of punitive, we're not doing enough, are we?
I will take that for the last. My first blame is to us, the entire society. We are growing so tolerant of things that we want to use modernity to say it's okay. Like, let me visit this issue of, sexual preference and all that. So why are we talking about it? We should allow them. Their preference is to gang rape. We should allow them. Society is becoming too tolerant. And you see the passion with which we condemn these things and expose them. I'm glad that in this particular case, there have been straight eyes, and the unit committee members have assisted, and bang, these boys are, some of them are behind bars. And I hear they are even in court this afternoon.
Well, they're being caught this afternoon. Yes, yes. On the beat for us. So
the second blame is parenting. Parenting has gone to the box. It's like bring people into the world and leave them. Somehow they'll fend for themselves.
So we're not raising our children, we are rearing them.
And it's even worse.
We're rearing them.
No, it's even worse. We have left them on their own. We are not even rearing. And you just get by. Find something to eat, do what you have to do. We go through what we call the establishment. We did go to school, do this, and then if you have the money. And these are students.
I'm happy to talk about go to school. And like you rightly said, they're students.
They're students.
So if parenting has failed or is failing, what about the classroom? What kind of education are we giving these young ones?
I think that we should bring moral education back and Bible knowledge back into the curriculum. But having said that, the teachers, I believe, are trying.
Is trying enough?
But even the parents are worse.
No, but it's trying.
Because you see, these people, they did it at home.
So don't we spend more time in school these days than even the home?
We do. So I have admitted that yes, the teachers must take some of the responsibility.
And again, people,
but you see, the number one reason why the teachers would say we are trying is that it's not their primary responsibility to raise your child for you.
But you see, but if you and I know, yes, parents have a role to play.
David, I will accept part of the blame for teachers.
Let me push in something here.
Yeah, please do.
Mm-hmm. What I want to say is this: that many will tell you that they picked up some vices when they went to school. At home, to a large extent, parents, some good parents, would observe their children and put them right when they go wrong and all that. But when people go to school, that's where they learn to smoke, drink, chase girls, rap them, gang rape. So most of these things are from the schools.
No, I wouldn't entirely say that it is the fault of the schools. You see, when people get together, even as when we're in the university, that's when it's like, you know, social activities. Of course, thank God we were more responsible, we were adults. Mm. So, but once we get together, there's that spirit of, you know, socializing. And that one, I agree that there has to be supervision, especially when they are in a boarding house and so on and so forth. But you see, they go for intercourse, then they go and, you know, try something small.
Because of these,
they have exeat.
Mm.
And this, the normal breaks, which is beyond the protection of the school.
Because in some,
but I agree that some schools are lax.
Yes, but Doc, in some in some of the schools, things are done because they are, let me put it in quotes, like rituals. Even if you go to your tertiary, the universities, there are some things that some halls, people who go to particular halls do, and it runs through. So you come from your home, you come from a secondary school, you're not exposed or used to some of these things until you get there. And it's like, it's a tradition, it's a norm. So once you're there for whatever months or years, you follow suit or same.
You see, that's what my problem is. That's a very interesting conversation, but I believe that that can be expanded another time. Mm. Except that to say that those are adults, consenting adults, and they can be, you know, dealt with the full rigors of the law because they have the ability to choose. This, we are talking about young ones that we need to protect.
The minors.
We need young ones that we need to inculcate. They are not majors yet. When you are 18 and above, you can answer to your own, you know, misdeeds. But these are young ones. I mean, is that the kind of preparation we are giving them?
But the question is,
that the kind of training we are giving them? So for schools that train these ones, I'll apportion some of the blame. But parenting has gone to the dogs. My emphasis is that parenting has gone to the dogs. Some of the parents take their awards to school and they feel that the teachers must train them. They are only counterparts in helping you to raise your child.
Your
primary responsibility is yours.
Have you seen the video? Erasmus, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, David.
How are you?
Well, I'm well.
How did it go?
You mean the papers and... it went well. By God's grace, it went well. We shared our brains on various issues. The rest is up to those who mark to see whether we've done well or we did it.
And I know that the results will be, you know, pasted on.
But in fact, we have wonderful lecturers at CSUC. And in fact, my main fancy hair. You're being mischievous. I know where you're directing this whole thing. But let me say good afternoon to one person who has been monitoring me and has been following my work. Sometimes he calls and says, you have to work this area up and all that. Nanamono.
Okay.
Nanamono Bakope.
Who's Nanamono?
Oh, you don't know him.
No, I don't.
He's all over Kumasi. If you want the best tires,
yeah,
he's a tire dealer. and he follows Love FM like nobody.
When they say Thai, flying Thai, and I said,
I mean, car ties.
We need to
and they say,
we are booked.
So, no, when you're Thai, Papa, I'm going to
give you an invoice.
But I'm going to good afternoon. Wherever you are,
I'm just tired. I'm sure that this girl who, you know, we saw in that video, who was, you know, who's alleged to have been raped by seven or so guys, is not in a good mood. I don't think that she's even correct up there in
she
the head.
Be traumatized.
Have you seen the video?
I don't want to see the video.
Well, and you it was given to me.
I'm one person who has been mounting crusades against sharing of
some of these things,
sexually explicit videos on social media. I'm against it. I have mounted several crusades against this thing. If you get a video and you share, you are also partaking in the crime that is being committed. Mm. So when you get the video, don't.
But let's talk about this alleged act itself that took place at Bantam.
You see, we are breeding monsters. And I've always said it. We are raising and breeding monsters.
Like animals.
And it's like the whole society unconsciously is supporting what's the other word for animal behavior? See,
you know,
and the way we are going about it, you see, consciously or unconsciously, you might be contributing to what is happening, but you might not know.
Yeah.
We are in a country where we glorify alcoholism and sex. How many alcoholic beverages have been advertised? How many of these herbal products? Now they are all not solving the malarias and other things again. Now everything is sexual potency. For who?
Sexual enhancement beverages. And
for who? And then the youth are capitalizing on it. And even the women who are supposed to be championing chastity and all that, they make fun of their bodies and they subscribe to it and they are happy. You pass certain comments about the woman's body, and even women who should be condemning it are happy and they are glorifying it. We listen to this in our music, we see it in our videos, we see it everywhere.
Especially the videos. I wanted to comment on that very one, because oftentimes the men are well dressed, some jeans, some suits, some you know, fully dressed. Women are half naked and shaking something that they think, you know, they have, so they need to flaunt it. They're shaking their buttocks everywhere. And then they give you innuendos. They go down and they do.
One word that is going around and people are glorifying it. It's so dirty. Twerking. You see it on social media and people use it, and you know the women are glorifying it. They're happy that you shake a certain part of your body.
They're
wriggling and whatever. And what kind of messages are we sending?
And we sit down and we don't talk about it.
See, this morning I posted something on my Facebook page. I was thinking I could read it to you, and then based on that I will make some submission. I posted it here that, okay, I said, why would young men rape a teenage girl in tents and film it? Ghana is yet to firmly establish prosecution and justice delivery of grave consequence for such dastardly acts. We are yet to establish seriousness with such crimes. The road to justice for a victim of defilement or rape in Ghana is so crooked, inhumane, and dusty that it favors the perpetrator more than the victim. The attitude of police investigators, who are sometimes influenced by the perpetrators if they are rich, the monies demanded from the victim for sometimes arrest of the suspects, and they will tell you, no fares, no car, you know, I'm the only one here, you have to provide some money before we go and arrest so and so. Okay. Money is demanded by doctors to sign police medical forms. Lack of protection for victims amidst threats from suspects, insults and insinuations from society. And just this afternoon, my colleague went to the scene of the crime. And you know what some of he reports that some of the family members are saying, oh, Achana, 1 week. Me and Fimi, they are for no mudi mochi bebre. Na China 1 week. Na I die down. No be dia.
Isn't it true? Isn't it true? You and I sat in the same studio as Erasmus barely 4 weeks ago.
Yes.
We had the Dofsu boss.
here. We had some doctor.
And he admitted that sometimes they are forced to even stop prosecuting a case because there is no medical form. The person cannot afford a doctor to sign a medical form.
And the doctors, we are told, sometimes even charge money.
That's what I'm saying.
The doctors, I think it's a good time to...
Let me finish my statement. The back and forth in court, if the case even gets there, all this embolden people to think it won't get anywhere, there's no consequence if I do this to somebody. And I said, let's respect women and children in this country. Let's create a robust protection for them. You see, in my documentary, which of course I wanted it to air this year, but I'm being told that it might be airing next year. It might be airing next year. See, you trace the prosecution line. When something like this happens to a child or a lady, you know, somebody's raped or defiled, one, the society itself doesn't believe something like that happened to you. And they feel that you have caused it. They feel that victims are somehow, the cause of their own problems. And so people cast insinuations from all of this and all that. When you try to follow justice, then some people come around, wave Germanic, are you the first to be raped or defiled or something like that? So gradually, we are creating a situation where when you are raped, it's normal. Why should you be complaining?
But Doc, what Erastus is saying, and one particular statement he made was the fact that, media for 1 week, brings me to this question that these things happen in our society. And this year, at least, I've had the opportunity of talking about defilement and rape cases or issues like twice. Now, the very first one, I didn't discuss that one based on a case or an incident that had occurred. I felt that we needed to have a conversation around it, and we had it. The other one, yes, we organized a conversation based on some cases that had come up. But as a society, it's not annoying, appalling, disgusting that some of these things happen and then we talk about it for like 2 days or 3 days and then we forget it. We move on. We don't do anything whatsoever to ensure that it doesn't happen again.
I think that that is a bit worrying. It's like, you see, life is a balance between punishment and reward. I keep saying. So if people think that you can do something and get away with it, then they will do it and eventually get away with it. I think the media does try sometimes, especially programs like yours that keep on. Maybe what should be done is that once a while, about every 3 months, you pick one case and say, what has happened to this case? And, you know, play it back. It's like, you know, what did they call it? A rollback Thursday or a rollback?
Throwback.
Whatever. And then bring it up, that case again. So some accountability and some answers must be demanded. And you are good at getting the people involved, whether the police or the lawyers or doctors, to, you know, give some kind of feedback and then to let us know an update of what has happened. I think that will help. The situation where we just talk about it 2-3 days and stop, that's what is feeding into this.
But you see, do we have to even restrict it to just talking about it? So if the media doesn't bring that in up, the structures, the system itself cannot bring up.
I believe that is helping the institutions.
You've gone round. You know that there are challenges from society, challenges from the family, the body that is supposed to, you know, help in terms of the police and the doctors and all that. They themselves have their own challenges. So as a nation, the question is, as a nation, are we prepared to ensure that we fight this,
you see,
such that it doesn't happen again?
The last time I heard the gender minister talk about the advocacy role that her ministry should be playing, and in fact questioning the mandate of that particular ministry, I have been asking myself, what was it, gender and women or
children,
whatever,
and social
children
protection.
And social protection? What is it for? That ministry?
That
what
social
is
social safety
for?
Net is
what is it for? Supposed to fight for some of these people who go through some of these things.
Question. Even
what does it do, actually? Because I don't see it. Somebody should tell me. That ministry, since time immemorial, since its inception up to now, what does it do?
I think that it needs to gradually improve its coverage. And just
no, Dr. Kwaku, yeah. It's a pertinent question I need answers to. What has it do? What has it done?
As for the social safety net, it's almost non-existent. Because I've had occasion to rise strongly at the time my own friend Nana Oileta was there, where there was a case about children being, you know, deferred for fish, in exchange for fish.
But it is still going on.
Yes.
Quite recently there was a documentary.
It is still going on.
You know, documentary that was put together.
Children are being abused.
Yeah, so the social safety
parents are maltreating their children.
But would it be wrong for that same ministry, you know, to say, for example, that such a thing has happened, and the victim and the family do not have the funds to chase it, you know, to its very logical conclusion, and so the ministry says, "Well, we voted this amount of money, and so police
they should be able to do this, it,
pay for medical bills
in conjunction with drugs. You
give some money,
social welfare.
I have always
been saying,
social
welfare.
You see,
and the social welfare, the rashes will tell the social welfare is a miser.
But Dr. Kwaku,
and then drugs. You,
Dr. Kwaku is talking about strengthening institutions. If the media's role is to sound some of these go on these advocacy things just to strengthen institutions, we've been doing it. I remember I've been doing stories.
I don't think we should give up
social welfare since
change may be slow and frustrating, but that's
but about 15 years ago when I started journalism, I started doing stories on social welfare department. I have not stopped. Nothing remarkable.
We need to keep on.
No, but when we have institutions that are supposed to protect children, the institutions themselves are weak. So right now, if a child is in danger, what is the helpline? Where does that child go? But what kind of help is there?
You do believe that what we are doing gradually is helping strengthen.
It's not strengthening.
I don't feel it. Doc, sorry.
It's not strengthening.
Doc, one other thing that hurts me here is, let's say that this gender ministry is not doing what is required of it. What about our traditional rulers? What about churches? They're also sitting quiet.
Good question.
They hear that some of these people are suffering to even raise money to do blah, blah, blah. You collect collections or whatever it's called at the end of every Sunday or during the week when you host prayer sessions and all. And members of your church, your congregation, are being raped, defiled. They are dying, and the church keeps quiet.
There used to be a time when our society was governed mainly by traditional authority and somewhat religious authority. Even without political authority, we were fine. Yeah. So I think we should... You know, like David, you are right. We should visit
another area.
And if the chiefs, the traditional rulers,
and another area,
if they don't have a direct interest in there that will favor them, no matter my dream.
David, another area. Now this is new, and I'm throwing a challenge to them.
To them being,
I know that you,
okay,
David,
okay,
belong to several WhatsApp groups.
Yes, I do.
What do you guys do?
Or sometimes some of these is like you know. We talk about some of these things.
Dr. Kwaku, we belong to several WhatsApp groups. What do they do?
The purpose for which it was set up, then
do you know what people do? Many of them, as I have seen, and I belong to one, they talk and talk and talk and talk and talk,
like need to
and fight no amongst themselves, and then organize, get together during seasons, and then they chop, finish, die. Why can't we, as groups like legal groups, you set themselves up? This is a WhatsApp group, we are championing this cause. All vulnerable, all victims of so and so who come up. We have set up this challenge. If you need help, call this helpline. We are ready to help you. This is an association of whatever, but this is what we want to do to help champion this cause. Can't we do that? After all, that will be our contribution to this canker.
Okay, I see.
So let's start doing something, including you and I. Let's start doing something. Aside sitting on radio and sitting in our homes and talking about it.
Because the conversation starts like you have given a good suggestion, which I believe some listeners will hear and take up. So after the conversation, David, just indulge me a bit.
I will.
You see, this issue about police form, I think, let me get something off my chest about police form and doctors signing. And during Nkrumah's time, we redesigned the, you know, if you like, medical form. When I would call it medical form, not even police form. During the Nkrumah's time, I, even when I was training as a medical student, I was there. Then I started working, it was there. I have my own personal views about signing police forms. I don't believe that, never mind, you know, but my own personal views don't matter. But there used to be something written on it that you are supposed to pay, I think, was it one CD in Krumah's time to the medical practitioner. Why? Because as the arrangement would have it, if the case goes to court and you are supposed to come and defend, you find your, you foot your own transport, you take care of yourself, find your own there all the time. If the case will last 2 years, you will have to. So it was paid as a token, not even enough to offset your bills. Now there's enough advocacy that I think has changed. Who now the responsibility that should the police or the court system absorb if it becomes necessary, that you should go and give I would say expert opinion, should it be absorbed by the police or the court system? Because we must look at it. But somebody must underwrite the charges.
It's
a question that I'm just doing.
Human as we are, can't we be a bit?
That's what I'm going to say. That's what I'm going to say. I am saying personally. Personally, but that's as my own views on matter here.
No, I understand, but what I'm asking,
what you saying it on radio, I don't do it. In fact, police form, I've signed only once and I didn't charge, even when I was
Can we have professionals like you, let's say the GMA for example, saying that we have come together, we are setting up a helpline. If anybody who has been abused sexually needs medical attention and form, we are taking it pro bono. Just like we have some lawyers, lawyer associations who have set up.
That's a
saying,
call that
this is what we are going to do.
A call that can be made.
Can we have a group of doctors saying
when there's a perpetrator involved in any case? Erasmus, when there's a perpetrator involved in any case, you know, tangential charges are made to that person by the police and the court. Why can't that part of that fee be used?
I'm talking about problem.
It's not always, doc. I said that call has been taken up. Yeah. I'm also giving another suggestion because not everybody may think alike. So that the case can go on. It's not everything that I'm happy that officially is being scrapped or is being scrapped, but the alternative must also be debated. I don't mind. I even my normal care, I do things
again, David. That's where the Social Protection Ministry comes in. So this thing, they cannot even think around the box and come up with a solution. It's been there for ages. Medical forms deterring people from coming forward.
We need to ask ourselves: is this? Do they care? That's number one.
Yes.
Are they concerned?
And that's why I've been asking you that gender ministry or whatever it is.
If you are an adult, if you are an adult in the community, and then you can open your mouth and say or pass comments like, "Now, I'm not quite in the year ripping, and no, so no, and the frame and the ban or so." Shame on you. Don't you have a conscience? We live in a society where if it's me, then I feel it. If somebody's daughter, we don't really care.
Charlie, we're
building a society, Erasmus, and I've been saying this for some time now. If we're not too careful, the next 5 to 10 years from now,
We are becoming too tolerant.
To handle smooth.
And the police
will be so rampant.
The police and law enforcement, we beg you. If society will be orderly, you are the ones that will help. We are supposed to protect life and property. Please.
16-year-old.
Stop. I'm getting tired of the police always saying that they are unable to do their job because politicians hamper them. Please, but that argument is tired now. You are right. In the last few cases that I've heard, I think that a trend is emerging that punishment is meted out and action is usually swift. In the last 3 or 4 cases that I've followed, which is commendable, but I think this argument is getting tired.
This is Christmas.
Yes.
And we're here to have a conversation. I mean, around Christmas, people do things that they want to have fun. So they might smoke something, drink something, to have impaired judgment, and then they go out to do some of these foolish things.
I am learning, and in fact, I have seen people on the ground use some of these things. Alcohol laced with marijuana. They call some of them shocker. They call some of them...
Is it lacquer?
Laka. They have Shoka, they have Laka, they have other ones.
Yeah.
In fact, some of them are biscuits laced with wheat.
Some of them are toughest.
In fact, I traced even one kid. I traced him, like I followed him. He went to show me where he buys them. We even bought one at Amakum. There is another joint somewhere inside Ahinsai.
Well, where the FDA?
Where they sell these things? You think they don't know? They know. The one at Amakum is broad daylight. People injecting themselves at Amakum is there. It's not public knowledge. It's not something that Erastus is saying.
This one, there's people nothing hampering the police because there's no politics involved here.
And so, as we go into Christmas,
people must be protected against themselves.
If you are a parent, and me, I won't leave my 18-year daughter to go along with friends alone and go and have fun somewhere. I don't know. Please, I won't do that. And I know that every responsible parent will not do that.
Look, this alcohol is a problem. Alcohol is
there should
problem.
Be supervision.
You see, that was what I was
well,
talking
I'm
about.
Well, I'm even happy that the FDA arrested. I pray that is true. That from next year they will not allow for some of these beverages to be advertised.
I welcome that news. In fact, I welcome that news, Papa.
Look, can I create some controversy here?
Listening.
I think there's a particular alcoholic brand, and it's making itself an octopus, and sponsoring everything.
Almost
very soon it will attempt to sponsor the Catholic Bishop Conference.
Yes,
you are sponsoring sports where there are kids involved, and you say that there's nothing wrong. You do it, and then you say that they drink responsible. If you are not 18, don't sports for kids. Don't you know that 50-year-olds they play sports and we even pay them? And sports prime time, you are all over advert sponsoring everybody. RTPs, this, that. Very soon they will attempt to sponsor the Catholic Bishop Conference.
The media
what
is
this?
Blame. No censorship.
What is this?
No censorship. But
it's like I was saying it somewhere else, and somebody said, he has money, he's making money. So, I mean, he can.
Making money.
My goodness. Money at the expense of people's life. Alcohol is a problem.
It's not a drug.
Around this Christmas, it is technical. It is. Around Christmas, it's the most. We have become the most tolerant the world over. It's more dangerous than cocaine, heroin, amphetamine, methamphetamine, and so on. It's very dangerous. It causes more injury and death than
and
any of them.
A lot of people
this Christmas, people think that, okay, when social drinking, I think the first thing that we need to say about alcohol is that when you drink it has an effect on your brain, on your what we call the central nervous system, your brain and spinal cord together, but especially on your brain. There are three effects that I would like to caution listeners about. And notice that this can happen to anyone if you take alcohol beyond moderation. You can have what we call euphoria. Your mind become hey. Then
and it drives different reactions in different.
Yes, areas. You can have impaired judgment.
Yeah.
Some say disinhibition.
Mm.
Okay. Then the three, you have increased confidence. I call it stupid confidence. Now with these three combined, you can be Captain Planet of sex or anything. These young people. When you go out during this Christmas, when you are not 18, at least by law, I can see it because don't drink. It's against the law.
Law.
If you have
to go out there, they are 14 and people sell alcohol. You don't even know where the person is taking the alcohol to. And also if you are 18, don't drink. People are buying alcohol. You don't ask them.
Even if you are a major. You are an adult and you are drinking in moderation because you may go out harmlessly. Like even on a harmless date, the ladies beware. You go out a harmless date, Christmas or Yuletide, and then you take alcohol. I would like to caution you that alcohol contains some basic something we call it OH or hydroxyl. So it doesn't matter whether it's whiskey, whether it is wine, whether it is
brandy,
champagne
or whatever.
It's the same content, so it can have same effect.
Mm.
So it doesn't matter this one, the Christmas
about
beware. Do not, when you go out and you don't take alcohol, especially you've never taken it before, don't let anybody, coax you into drinking it. You may lose your senses and this may happen to you.
What about this?
The young man, when you take all these things, it's against the law, but when you take them, look, you know that it can drive you towards plans that you have not made, including gang rape and sex.
Mm.
When you do that and the law catches up with you, you have been foolish.
There's another one you're missing. Perhaps I have heard it. Spanish fly or something.
Okay, those are
for animals, for horses to produce
but
more.
These days, I'm hearing through certain circles.
So they did.
They put drops in.
No, that time,
is it still back now? I have heard that people still
despise those
flies. Yes.
Yeah, but that's also criminal.
But again, it is. But the point is this.
I'm saying it for people to be aware.
Yeah,
you might be a lady.
So your drinks, when you go, empty your glass. You know, they come and
go to the bathroom and you come back.
Don't continue that same.
Don't continue that same.
Please, alcohol too, you know, around this festive occasion, alcohol is the number one thing that we'll talk about because it changes everything. You are using it as a social beverage to improve your happiness. But even arguments can break between ordinary people who are not violent. Please, when you have taken some alcohol and disagreement breaks, please, the first thing you should remember if you listen to this program is to turn and walk away. The last year we had human bite, very gory at a emergency. Disagreement with friends, bit the other. Some have stabbed each, and so on and so forth because there's alcohol involved. So when you have taken alcohol and disagreement breaks during this festival for your friends, brothers, turn and walk away.
We have talked about the fact that an amount, depending on your capacity in terms of alcohol intake, can impair judgment. Here you're saying I walk away. My dream may be, I'm not reasoning well.
There's something
walk away.
I like that question. And it's a good one. There's something about what we call premeditated thought. That's why we are doing this program before the Yuletide.
Yeah.
That's why you timed it this way.
Yeah.
So once you have preventive education in your mind, it reminds you before you can cross over to the level of stupidity. And you are able to master the will and turn away. You see, so it is in this program we are doing now is important. That remember that when you have taken alcohol, ordinary things that would not be a problem, it can be a problem. So when you have disagreement with your neighbor, it can be your brother. Last year it was between two brothers, the human bite. Then there were two cases of stabbing between friends. So remember that when you have disagreement, it's not to prove that you are right. Please turn and walk away. Even consider yourself foolish.
Okay.
So that we can enjoy together. Maybe you have prepared some impusio and then you have some drink that you are sharing. Well, don't overdrink. But if you do, enjoy the impusio and not stab each other or bite each other.
Why do we focus on alcohol as the only thing that makes
In this particular case, all our experience with medical emergencies,
during the first emergency,
alcohol is the number one offender in this.
Let us not think that it's only when you sit with friends, the one they call sitting, that is the only happiness associated with every festive occasion. There are other things you can do. There are other things. I know people who don't drink. But when they meet around a table, they create fun. There are other things. You can watch a movie. You can do so many things. You can go sightseeing. Lots of places. You can even bring the family together. So if you are going to areas where you know that per experience is a trouble spot or a hot spot,
you don't go there.
You don't go there.
And that's why we're asking you to bring your children out on the 24th and 25th to the Rat Tree.
Have a nice time with them.
And we wouldn't take alcohol, but we'll be there to make them happy. I mean, Uncle Erasmus Asaredonko, Uncle Kofi Diakwa,
Uncle Gorgeous, please.
But when we return,
sorry for sounding overindulgent, but I want to stress again that when you take alcohol, three things can happen to you. You can have effect on your brain. You can have euphoria. You can have impaired judgment or disinhibition. You can have increased confidence. It can let you engage in sexual acts that you haven't planned to do before. And it can also make you indulge in violent activity. So we should be aware. Preventive education is that when you have taken alcohol and you have disagreement, turn and walk away. You'll be considered a fool.
Yeah.
Or if you are tempted to have sex, don't do it, because if you're a minor, for instance, you'll be prosecuted in a juvenile court as it's being done. Ladies, beware.
Okay.
When you go out on a date and somebody is trying to coax you and cajole you into taking alcohol, especially if you haven't taken it before, no. If you went out with a harmless date, don't take it. Enjoy. but stay away because it's the number one cause of these.
Some ladies do it intentionally. They go under the name, brand name, Yekonom. It also creates problem.
So
some men will not just go.
We'll be right back. But again, we have changed the conversation this afternoon. I mean, we wanted to give to our listeners what we call the festive emergencies, as to what they can do in terms of an emergency, you know, a medical concern. For example,
ordinary food poisoning and all that. Maybe we can squeeze in a little bit.
We would because this is quite necessary. Yeah. Mm. I often say this, that Erasmus has a very beautiful girl, and so he's protective. He's overprotective of her. I've got two
children.
I've got two.
In fact, I love children.
And, yes, two girls. Doc, you also have two. So I was told about this video. As like I said, I didn't watch it, but I said to myself, I would
be very surprised if those young men were not under the influence.
Well, we'll be right back. You are
great. Yes, you are. The Word of God is a strong foundation, a rock that keeps us standing through the storms of life and exposes our innermost thoughts and desires. Join the International Central Gospel Church Trinity Temple, Kwadaso, every Sunday from 8 to 10:30 a.m. as we help you discover your purpose through life-transforming messages. Remember, the proof of a desire is the next pursuit. Don't miss our weekday services on Wednesdays and Fridays from 6:30 to 8 p.m. Your life will never be the same. Say you are great. Say you are great.
The sun is so bright and I'm feeling so dry. I need something to quench all my thirst. Something so pure and so healthy. Bell up for new life every day. Your new generation mineral water.
Aqua Mineral Water, your new generation mineral water. Look out for the elegant red label.
Give me new life every day. Bella Aqua.
Looking for a stop shop that meets all your beauty needs? Look no further, for your much anticipated unisex salon is here. It's the Beauty 360 Unisex Salon. We offer you the best of services using state-of-the-art equipment and quality products. Our services include hairstyling, men's grooming, pedicure and manicure, massage therapy, skin care, you name it. Our services are offered on walk-in basis or by appointment. We also provide consultation services on your hair, skin and facial. At Beauty 360, our team of experts add a touch of class in everything they do. We treat you to good music and drinks whilst we work on you. You will definitely leave Beauty 360 smiling. We offer all these services at affordable prices and still make you the trend. You'll find us at the Santati Roundabout opposite the Unity Oil. You can also call us on 0244-601449. Book a date with us and let's leave you flawless. Beauty 360, we make you the trend.
Memory down the past area, my family cast off when I'm a promi engine. Next is the Enconquan. Meniche Ultimate Fashions. Any Ultimate Furniture City. Ultimate Fashions, that's your money, memmingra. That's my increase in my swagger. His son said, me qua designer chefs, BTC. Ref Ferdinando, Kenneth Cole, Max Fendi, Perry Jacobs. Any dia kika who be brave. Ningina, minya bito. Ultimate Bet Show Italian shoes, slippers, any sandals. Khaki, any material trousers. Office, any wedding wear. For the ladies, Ultimate were all kinds of American designs. Designer dresses. Send be a wedding away, engagement, and a dinner be, or party be, the old best shift is true costly form, and we Ultimate Fashions, what it? Brand IGD will we have to be our Ultimate, and will be Ellen Tracy and Adriana Papel, Jones, New York, Tahari, Casper, any baby. For today's perfect gentleman and lady, the only place to go are your Ultimate Fashions. Ultimate Furniture City. It's the furniture store be our so set, or more living room furniture, bedroom sets, dining room sets, garden, and a porch chairs. Actually, Ultimate Furniture. Because Ultimate, Omomokoya selection, and BNA Plus 3, and your money is fair, and your money is heavy, and your money is class. obi wrawo dem na se wo torn yo mefi ultimate furniture city a e wan we hu dibre make e shini ku tie yamba still ho look funky me see yan frame ultimate kwa ifi bi binti ultimate fashions and furniture city simply a touch of style medu ultimate e wedum methodist in chenwa
This gate. Back. Hey, Mr. Techi, please come and help me open my gate, I beg you. What is wrong with this gate? You know, this is the second time I've changed this gate after the thieves broke into my shop 2 months ago. When I open it, it always gets stuck in the middle here. I don't know why. I'm even tired of it.
Papako, I've always been telling you, never compromise on quality. You see, I've been using my roller shutter gate for the past 10 years, and I have never had any problems with it because I got it from Donima Steel Complex. Donima Steel Complex provides quality roller shutter gates at affordable prices. They are of high quality and impossible to break in. That's not all. They have the manual and automatic gate systems, which are ideal for warehouses, domestic stores, and garages. And they are installed by professionals without any extra charges.
Had I known.
Locate Donima Steel Complex at Asafo, YF Junction, near the Ghana Revenue Authority office. Or call 0244-126-625. Donima Steel Complex, home of tropical products.
For the past 12 years, New Generation Investment Services Limited, a leading investment banking firm, has guided thousands of institutions and retail investors to make millions in secured portfolio investments. New Generation Investment Services Limited is licensed by the Securities and Exchange Commission and the National Pension Regulatory Authority. We offer Treasury Bill Plus fixtures for our products such as fixed deposits, premium investments, NGI's child care investment, and Diamond Plus investment plans, as well as manages Tier 2 and Tier 3 pension funds. NGI's Limited also manages the Enidasu Mutual Fund. Talk to our seasoned investment advisors now and we will structure an investment portfolio for you. Visit us at first floor Kokobo Jubilee House, Adum Kumasi, and second floor Abosoma Kutre House near Koko House, Sunyani, or our website www.ngis-group.com. Call us in Kumasi on 03220-91608 or in Sunyani on 0352-197-482. New Generation Investment Services Limited, achieving excellent returns on your investment.
All right, so we, you know, on the dietary, we wanted to bring to you a conversation on festive emergencies where we wanted to tell you some of the things we can do by way of helping our own selves and our children, you know, in case of any emergency, like food poisoning and all that. But we had to change the conversation because of the severity of what happened over the weekend. And of course, many have talked about it. We're talking about the alleged gang rape by seven of this young girl. Now, the annoying thing or the sad thing is the fact that they're all teenagers and underage, and they're doing these things. And the fact that they have the confidence to say, we're filming this, I ask myself, what were they thinking? You can give us a call. We're 5 minutes to go, but give us a call now on 03220-83596. Do you have concerns too? What would you love to see happen? Erasmus has talked about the gender ministry and the fact that he thinks that the gender ministry is so dominant, it's not doing enough. From your own angle, from your own perspective as a citizen, as a Ghanaian, as a human being, what would you want to say? What would you want love to see happen? Because you didn't So you can give us a call. Let's have a conversation. Good afternoon. Your line dropped there. But the phone lines are still activated on 03220-83596. Doc, you know, let me pick a few calls, but I'd like to, for you to tell me, do you think that enough is even being done for the girl in question? I'll take a response shortly. Hello, good afternoon. Hello? Hello? What's happening to my phone lines this time?
I think...
Hello? Wow. Let me try this line then. Hello, good afternoon. Hello. Hey, Gabriel Enko, please, I need some help and come and assist me. Doc, please let me hear you.
Yeah, I think the young girl needs a lot of psychotherapy.
Mm.
Right now, she's not of herself.
Mm.
So it's good that the police is keeping in custody. The psychiatrist must be involved,
mm-hmm,
and the psychologist. Let's keep her because she's in post-traumatic stress. So we should do that. And then support her, screen her for any sexually transmitted infection, for pregnancy, the unwanted pregnancy, and so on and so forth. And then I think that this victim must be supported to be able to realize whatever ambition that she has, to serve as a good example of rehabilitation.
Let me try this line, see if it's working. Hello, good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon.
Hi, okay, it's not working. Good afternoon to you. Thank you very much for your time. What's your name, please?
Sherry.
Sherry, welcome. Let's say Sherry Daniels.
Yeah. it's so sad. Putting myself in that young girl's shoe is very, very sad. But the thing is, the videoing issue, this thing has been going on for several years, even adults videoing their sex partners, and nothing has been done about it. So that's why those small, nyati boys, and they are doing those things. And about the alcohol, they portray beautiful girls, handsome guys taking the alcohol on TV. They don't show us the repercussions, and that's why the youth, they are still indulging in that.
I hear you.
It's so disheartening.
It is indeed disheartening. Thank you very much, Sherry Daniels. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Kalusha, let's hear you, Kalusha.
David, I got submission. David, I always say, if prescription force must apply. David, on your own news item today, those suspected to have killed the Captain Muhammad has been freed. Today, somebody has been jailed 8 years for stealing a mobile phone.
18 years or so, yeah.
18 years. Thank you, David. But David, I tell you what, if the punishments are not severe, this thing will keep on coming. David, those who enforce the laws themselves are suspects. And I tell you what, this case will be a dead case. David, it's time our laws should work. This thing would never happen.
It's time our laws work, so says Kalusha. And I agree with you, Kalusha, there. Good afternoon.
David.
Alaji Abu.
Good afternoon,
sir. Let's hear you, boss.
David, our problem in this country, all over, radio stations, television stations, every time, adverts about alcohol. Previously, it wasn't so. When we were young, those things, I think that they don't even talk about it. It's elderly people who goes in for alcohol. But now, between the ages of 14, 15, 16, because you've seen it on radio, listening to radio, television, display alcohol, even sponsoring so many programs, like musical programs, you know. So, the problem is with alcohol. These young men, SHS students, they go in for alcohol. When we're in school, we don't know what is alcohol. But now the advert has